Hi friends, in this video we will see the use of defined property in JavaScript objects. Let's say I have one object with name person is equal to id as 1 and name as Leela. Okay, now if I try to print the person dot id, if I try to print the person dot id, I will get the output as 1. Okay, fine. Now I will change the person dot id as 4. Now I will try to print the output of person dot id. So you will be able to know that the person dot id will be changed, but here I am able to change the id of the person wherever I want when you are going into the code, but I don't want this type of scenario. I want to remain the id as a constant that should not be changed by anyone while proceeding through the code. So how can we do this one? We can achieve this one using the defined property. Now I can delete this id, and what I can do is here object dot defined property. Okay, object dot defined property. So for which object you want to define the property? I want to define the property for person. And what is the property key you want to define? Id. And what is the value you want to define as 1. Okay, so this is how we can define the object property. Now what I will try to change is, I will try to change the person dot id is equal to 4. Okay, now what I will do, I will try to print the output after defining the here. So now if I try to print the output, I got both the time as 1 only. That means first time when we print the person dot id, we got the 1. Why? Because we defined it as 1. Now we tried to change the value to 4, but it didn't get changed. It remained only the previous value only. So this is how we can maintain the id as a permanent without maintaining anyone to change the value of the id. If you want to change the value of id, you can write as writable as true. If you change this, you key had this key, now it got changed. See, this is how you can have full control to the property in the object. You can have the full control like this. Okay, and also for example, see, you can maintain underscore id is equal to 1 or something like this. Okay, and also you can maintain here getter and setters also. So for example, you will be maintaining like that, and you can have here getter as function, okay, and setter as function. Okay, and now you can whenever the used person tries to, you can return the value id is plus this dot id. You can use like this also. Now whenever I try to use person dot id, the value will be written like this. So if you see here, what is this happening? Okay, fine, you need to return this underscore id, right? Okay, now if I try to see, id is 1 and id is 1. So whenever I'm trying to use the person dot id, it is written like this. So you can have a wrapper or something like that in outside the thing. Whenever they want to access the id, you can access like this. And also you can use this dot underscore id is equal to id. You can assign like this also. Now if I try to do, you got id is 4. So this is how you can have the getter and setter functions in the defined property also. So this is the use of object dot defined property in the JavaScript. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.